The idea was good. The execution, not so much.
We're not going to budge for that little itty bitty minty that is in there, hun. You need to give us a little bit more.
Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video, which is going to be extremely dramatic because it's going to be another best of beauty. And in today's video, I am going to go over the products that I tried in the month of October and giving you my final thoughts and being extra dramatic because I feel like it today. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love being dramatic just as much as I do, if you love to chat about makeup, if you love to be inspired by unusual color combinations, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. You are still going to be enrolled in our band, which is now post Halloween, but basically Nightmare Before Christmas. Yes, that is it. We were a huge hit. We blew the house down. Never mind. But yeah, as I said, this video is about all the products that I tried in the month of October. I did a bunch of videos with most of the stuff, or I have been trying out stuff just off camera, and I am giving you my opinion on it today. Now, I used to do it ranking style, but I like to be different, so I'm doing it tier style, and I have 5 tiers to choose from. The first tier is a hell no. It does not really need an explanation, does it? Then the next tier is meh. And in meh are the products that they're okay. They're not extremely bad, because then they would be in the bottom tier, but they're meh. How can I say they're meh? The next tier that I have is nice. That is the products that are nice, that are a very nice quality, that are, well, better than meh, but not amazing. Yes? And then the next tier is, oh my god, these are so good. And these are the products that are very, very good, that I would recommend over and over and over again. But they're just not my holy grail products. Because the next tier that I have is, you have to pry it out of my cold, dead hands. As I said, I like to be dramatic. That tier does not need any explanation either, right? So yeah, I will list all the products down below in the description box. And kind of without further ado, oh yeah, let me tell you what I have on my eyeballs. On my eyeballs, I have the Classical Paradise from Ace Beauté. I just filmed the comparison between the old formula and the new formula. That palette is not in this ranking though, because I'm filming this in the beginning of November. So that one will be in the Best of Beauty of November, if you want to know my final thoughts, because I just want to try it out a little bit more. Let's start though with something that had so much potential. I was so excited, and it disappointed me so much. It was from the Planet Revolution. It is their Mask Revival Reusable Sheet Mask system. So I have the sheet masks here, and I have the spray things here. Now, these are, they're nice. There's nothing really wrong with that. I prefer a sprayer that is a little bit more aggressive than the fine mist that they have. But remember that they have a fine mist. It will be important in just a second. So basically, you get 2 reusable, I think it's cotton sheet masks. So this is how they come. This is it. And it's just, I don't know who fits this though. Not me. But yeah, so basically, because there were 2, the one that I used is cut up, because I kind of want, I don't have a big head, but it's not that small, so I kind of cut it up to make it fit me. The idea is brilliant. The trouble that I have with this though is, because the spray of these is so very, very fine, I spray almost everything except the mask. Basically, I had to spray like a mother effer, and it did not really help, because the spray is too fine, so it doesn't really soak the cloth. So I was like, okay, let me wet it a hint, just a little, you know, that it is damp, maybe it will help a little bit. No, it doesn't grip the liquid well enough. So basically, instead of the jelly-like consistency that you get with a normal sheet mask, this is just a liquid. This is kind of a water consistency, so the mask doesn't hold the moisture where it should, and it kind of sinks down, and you have a lot of moisture here. Then I thought, well, let me just try the sprays then on their own. They are nice. It's nice, but the sprayer, as I said, when I sprayed it, it goes there instead of where I want it on my face. So I'm very, very sad though that I will keep this for Halloween or something. I'm very, very sad that this is just, it's the idea was good. The execution, not so much. And I'm so, so sad about it because I really, really wanted this to be a good product. But yeah, don't waste your money on it, honestly. Next, I have something that it's technically not a bad product, but it just doesn't do it for me. And that is this from X Revolution, their Lip Max. It feels very, very cheap. Let's just say that I have a lip plumper from Essence that feels more luxurious than this. So that was the first thing that I noticed. I don't mind the applicator. It's also basically a twist like with the Viper. This though, I like the formula. I like the fact that it is sticky, that it basically stays put. It has a hint of mint. So if you want a lip plumper that is very gentle, that basically just gives you the idea of a plumping thingy-majingy, or you're very, very new, this could potentially be something for you. But honestly, I would just go to Essence, because if you can get that, because that one is more plumping than this. For me, the only thing that it does is keep my lips from drying out, because my lips are like, yeah.
We're not going to budge for that little itty bitty minty that is in there, hun. You need to give us a little bit more.
So, for me, my lips are used to the Nabla Lip Viper. If that is too hefty for you and you really want to start with a plumping and you want something that has a minty, you can always try this. I would not pay full price though. Wait until a sale. Honestly, the one that I have from Essence, I have one here. They have two. They have this one, a red one, that has a little bit more plumpness than their original one. But even the original one from Essence is better than this one, according to me, because it has more mint, so it plumps more. It's my video, so I can bitch if I want. I can bitch if I want to. Never mind. Let's next go to a product that is here for one reason. And that's because it's not even this product's fault. It's just the consistency is too thin. That is it. It's from Makeup Revolution as well. And it is their Renaissance Flick waterproof liner. Now, the Renaissance Flick had been a favorite liner of me for years. And I have been wanting a waterproof one for years. Now we have one. You know what my eyes are going to do now? They're like,
we are crinkly.
And this liner is like,
yeah, but I'm so happy and I'm so liquidy.
And my eyelids are like,
we are crinkly.
So you know what we're going to do? We're going to do that. So this bleeds a lot. Yeah. So that happened. If you, though, want a thin formula and you want a waterproof one, this is a very, very nice. But for me, I don't know what happened to my eyelids. They're also not liking the brush ink from NYX anymore. The tattoo liner. It's just irrigation canals. That is what is happening. Yeah. So basically, if I want to have very much lines upwards, this is the formula. It's the formula. It's too thin. I need something that it is a little bit thicker and that basically stays put. Yeah. Honestly, it's not the product's fault, but it's my video. So I'm just blaming it on the product because it can never be me, just so you know. The next product that I'm going to mention, it is kind of on the cusp between a hell no and meh. So, but because this is a product that I can see myself reaching for, that's the reason that it is in the meh category. And that is from Sosu. It's the Bee Speckle Freckle Tint. Now, also, this packaging feels as cheap as the one from X Revolution. Just so you know. But this is, I want to say stift, but that's Dutch. I think you call it a Sharpie. I don't know. A marker. Yeah, we call that a stift. Just so you know, you learned something. This, I don't know if you can see it, but it looks very green. It's basically the same thing that I had with the ones from ColourPop. I can show you on my hand. Can you see? And I think that this is because of the fact that I have a blue undertone and a yellow overtone, which makes it a little bit green. Now, when it dries down on my face, it's a little bit better, but it is basically... Yeah, you can see what's happening, right? Also, I have just found out that I don't like this type of product. Well, the applicator. I prefer a brush. If you like the ones from ColourPop, the light pen from ColourPop, if that color works for you, this color will work for you as well. For me, you know what? I'm going to move it to the hell now, because I'm not going to use this again. Now, really looking at it, and on my face, it's not really green, but I know myself. Now that I know this, I'm not going to use this. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to give this to my sister or something. It's going to be demoted to the oh hell no category. Yes. Now we're going to go to the meh. So let's start with the first thing in the meh category, which is from Makeup Obsession, and it's one of their liquid blushes. It's a little bit of a thicker formula, but I wanted this color. Yeah, so let me show you the color that it is. Consistency, it kind of reminds me of the NYX the Sweet Cheeks. Yeah, the Sweet Cheeks formula. This is maybe a little bit more a waxy almost. Let me show you the color. This is the color. I know I am an olive, and that shades warp on me. That is why it is built up so much. But also, if you look at the... This is... See? So that's why it's here, because this is not orange. This is, I don't know, coral? It looks pretty. The color looks pretty, but it is constantly throwing me off because this is an orange tube and I'm like, yeah, I know it's not orange, but what color is it again? It's coral. And even if I blend it out, it's still not orange. My lips are orange. The tube is orange. It ain't orange. So that's why it's here. Do I have a clothy? Yeah. The formula itself is... Formula itself is nice. Yeah, it is. Okay, so that was the first... Yeah. Let's next go to... I think I'm going to switch this around. So next I'm going to go to brushes. And I kind of feel a little bit bad because I love the brand. I got these in PR. Out of the entire set... Honestly, there is one brush that I use regularly. There is one brush that I forgot I had, but that is a brush that I kind of... Let me just show you the set. It's from Alien Cosmetics. As I said, I'm very, very... I'm extremely particular with my brushes. They are very nice and soft, but it's not what I go for. Let me explain. So let me grab the face brushes first. So let me show you the brush that I use very, very regularly, and that's this one. That's the highlighter brush. I like the shape. I like it a lot. So that's the brush that I really do like out of the set. The next brush that I also like is this one, the Flat Top Kabuki. For the brush that it is, I really do like it. I think it is nice. It works well. It's not a brush that I don't use brushes like this often, but if I use a brush like this, this is one that I grab because I really do like that brush. Then we have these two. So this one I actually used today for my cream bronzer. Because my hair is silver, I need to be a little bit more precise with my placement because, otherwise you can kind of see what's happening here. I think it kind of stains it a little. My hair needs to be a little bit longer and then it's all okay. This one then has a nice shape, so I can really nicely tap it on, which I really like to do with my cream blushes. It picks up enough, but it doesn't pick up too much. I really like this one for cream blush, cream bronzer. Now I tried this one, which is the powder brush. I don't like this powder brush. And why don't I like this powder brush? Because I don't know what the hell to do with it. Because if I set my face, obviously the brush that I use is in my container because I need to wash it. If I set my face with powder, I use something like this. I use brushes like this for setting my face, for applying blush, for applying bronzer. So this is not a brush that I use. I can use it for bronzer. I can, but it's too dense for what I like. So I don't know what to do with this brush. I don't like this style of brush. It's not a brush that I use. The brush itself, there's nothing wrong with the brush, but it's not a brush that I like. Then we have these, which are the eye brushes. What I will use these two for are setting my applying my eyeshadow primer, because these are too dense and not dense enough. I told you I was particular with my brushes. I have more brushes like this in my collection that I don't use either, so it's not her. It's just that the fact that these brushes are too dense, not dense enough, too fluffy and not fluffy enough. They're just, for me, not it. And again, I told you I was particular. The other brush that I do like is this one, which is basically kind of a smudger brush for underneath. I really like that one. Yeah, even in my favorite brush sets, there are brushes that I never use. So I think they are very nice and soft. I think that if you like the shapes, you will like the brushes. I do have an affiliate code with Alien Cosmetics in case you want to save some money. But don't take my word for it, because I know that there are other people who also got this brush set in PR. So go, if you want to buy this set, go watch more reviews and not just rely on mine or anyone else's. Just, you know, weigh your options. The last thing that I have here in the meh category is here, because I think they're good quality for kind of what they are, for the price. And they're also in a bundle. It's the first part of the She Glam Ratchet Romance collection. These are the lippies. Now, I also have the eyeliners, but I have not formed my opinion on the eyeliners yet. Now, I did not use this one. I used four out of them, but the formula is the same. What I did notice, though, is that the black on me, it's not a true black. It pulls... was it the dark red? I think so. Maybe that is helpful. I do like these. These are lip creams. They are a little bit more on the sheer side, though. So if you want to build them up, especially the darker colors, if you want to build them up and make them not streaky, it's kind of getting... You need to build it up, but the formula is not really suited to building a lot. I feel, at least. I feel like, kind of like with the gloss from ColourPop, their Luxe Gloss. Because if I use that one, it's nice. But if I use a hint too much, it's kind of gloopy. It's kind of like this as well. So if I use a hint too much of this, I feel like, I don't know, I have put butter on my lips. It goes away and it's not, but it's not, I don't know, it almost feels heavy. I do really like the colors, though, and they do stay on. When they kind of set, they stay on. They don't stay on for an extremely long time, because they are lip creams. And as lip creams go, I think that they are nice. Now, when I tried these out for the first time, I compared them to the Kaleidos Lip Clays. Yeah, the Kaleidos Lip Clays are way, way better. They are a way more sophisticated formula. But if you want to try lip clays and you like these, yeah, I don't think that you can go very wrong with them. They are nice, and I will keep on using them. But when I want a sheerer formula, or on top of a lip liner, if you use a black lip liner or a black eye pencil to color in your lips, you can use this on top, no problem. It does not work well in combination with a gloss on top, though, because it stays a little bit more. It does not dry down completely. I hope that helps. So yeah, I do like them. And I will keep on using them, but they're not my most favorite. Yeah, they're meh. That's it. They're meh. Next category is the category of these are nice. And with nice, I mean the positive side of nice. So not that these are nice. But no, I mean they're nice. They're good products. That's it. They're good products. They're just not blowing my mind away for one reason or another. So it's maybe a little bit of a Twilight Zone. Because these are way too good to be in the meh category. But they are not good enough, in my opinion, to be in the, oh my god, these are so good category. So maybe a little bit in the Twilight Zone. I can call it the Twilight Zone. Let me know if you like that, the Twilight Zone. So then we will have a hell no meh Twilight Zone. These are amazeballs. And then you have to pry them out of my cold dead hands. Let me write that down, because I kind of like what I said. And otherwise, I forget. My memory card was full. Huh. So, yeah. Let's then What can you do about it? Let's then go to the Twilight Zone. I like it. We are going to keep it like that. Yes, the Twilight Zone. Let's start with the first product that I have here. And I think I failed to mention in the beginning that they're not really ranked, but they kind of are inside the tier, you know? Yeah, it happens. Let's go to another blush from Makeup Obsession. This is the shade West Peach. Now, it's the same thing as with the other one, but I like this color a little bit more. Right now, at least. So, yeah, maybe it's still peach, but it's on the pinker side of peach. I don't know. It's not, I don't think it's peach though, but some people will classify. I wish it was more orange. But I like this color on me right now a little bit more than the orangey one, and it doesn't piss me off as much. That is also something, so that's why it's a little bit higher than, yeah, the orange. The next product that I'm going to mention is, is an eyeshadow palette. I like the formula. I think the formula is very, very nice. I like the aesthetic. That's honestly why I bought it. Color story wise, it's not what I go for right now. And that is why it is a little bit lower in the tier than the rest. And that is from Makeup Revolution and Corpse Bride. Now, I love the way that this is looking. I love it a lot. Yeah, the color story as a whole, it's just not really something that I go for right now. And honestly, I did not really buy it to use a lot. I did want to try the formula, but I bought it more for the aesthetic. Yeah, not gonna lie. And this is a nice quality. No, this is also a little bit more shimmer heavy, I feel. And the mattes, these two mattes, yeah, they could have lost one. Because they are on the eyes, they are very, very similar. Basically, you have some bluer toned purples and you have some pinker toned purples. Then you get a blue and a red. Yeah, this, well, it's not, for me, it's not really a red. It's more of a pink, a very pinkish red, reddish pink, whatever. I think that the quality is very nice. I like the color story, but it's just, yeah, it's here. It's, what can I say? I like others a little bit more. Yeah, let's next go then to, and I also kind of looked at, sometimes in a tier, I looked at what will I grab for more often. Also that. And sometimes it's just the way that it is. So the next thing that I'm going to mention is the Makeup Revolution Tim Burton collab. And it is The Nightmare Before Christmas, the Jack highlighter. This is Moonlight Mischief and Madness. Can we just... I bought it purely for the packaging. Yeah, I did. I love this a lot. Look how cool. I did use this. And I really like the color and I really like the formula. I find this is one of their better highlighter formulas, I feel at least. Why do I say that? It's because I like a highlighter that is subtle but not non-existent. You know, that's subtle but that I can build up and it is a smooth formula. So I don't really like a highlighter that is too glittery. I just don't like that. I prefer a smooth formula. And this gives me from a nice soft highlighter. You know, soft highlighter. It will maybe not blind to the gold, but that's not usually what I go for. This is, I feel, a very nice everyday highlighter that I can spruce up if I want to. That I can tone down a little bit. But yeah, honestly, I don't think I will use it a lot. And the reason for that is not that I don't like it, but this is going to go on display. So I have Bomma as a highlighter. So again, this is not really why I bought it. But the formula, if you want to buy this to use, I think if you like a highlighter that is smooth, that is not instantly in your face, bam, you know, glow to the gods, then I think you will really like it. The next thing that I'm going to mention is, what can I say? It has spiders on it. What can I say? It's the eyeshadow palette from She Glam, The Wretched Romance. The reason that this is here is because it's a spider web.
What's not to love?
Also, the colors are very fun. Yes, I know it has two pressed glitters, but it's a spider web. So that's the reason that it is. And it has blood spatters in one of the shades. So that's why it's higher. And I really liked the quality. The shadows did not crease on me, but the Corpse Bride didn't crease on me either. I really like this. What can I say? So yeah, this is higher because it has a spider. Don't judge. It's my video, don't judge. let's go to this. And this is the last blush that I have from Makeup Obsession. It's the shade Rune Dust. I don't know why it's... Dune Dust, not Rune Dust. Why it is called Rust. Dune Rust. Wow, it's difficult apparently today. Now this is the most... It looks the most like the packaging. I know it warps a little bit on my hand, but when I first put it on, it looks kind of like the packaging. This on me is very, very pretty. It's a pretty neutral kind of a color that I can use very nicely on its own. You know, it's pretty... It's almost a nudish blush. I don't know. But I like it. I like it more than the other colors. That is why it is higher. And this is out of the three. I can also mix the colors, no problem. But out of the three, it's the one that I have used the most, I believe at least. Then I'm going to go to a foundation that I have on my face today. This is from Woma by Sharon. This was a gift, but I have been trying it out and I wanted to let you know how I feel about it. This is in the shade Fair Lady T5. Now, I have to mix this one always because it's not an olive, but that's okay. I prefer, honestly, the Woma foundation, the original Woma foundation. I feel like, and that's also a different price point, but I feel like for me, for what I like, the consistency that I like the Woma, the original foundation, a little bit more. However, that one is too dark for me, so I have to always mix it. But I like the consistency more because it's a little bit thinner. This is a little bit of a thicker consistency. It's also not as full coverage as the normal Woma. So basically, this for me is a light... not an extremely light, but a light medium to medium coverage. And I have it today. I have it on today. It kind of evens out my skin tone a little bit without... and it still shows everything through, you know, so that is why I mean by. I can build it up to medium, but I have to use, I think, 4 pumps, and I don't really like that. I think I can compare this in consistency a little bit to the Maybelline Superstay, but the Maybelline Superstay is full coverage, so Rimmel, maybe? I think so, or L'Oreal, kind of those. Yeah, I do like it. I think it's a nice foundation. Again, if you are looking for a medium coverage foundation, I don't think that you will be very disappointed with this. Now, my face is normal. It can get a little bit dehydrated if I don't drink enough water. It does not really settle into lines. It does a little, but not a lot. If I just use it for what it is nice. It does not crackle a lot or anything, or bunch up in weird places. If you're extremely dry, maybe this one is not for you, or prep your face correctly. But yeah, I think it's nice. It's not spectacular, but I think it's a nice foundation. And I kind of hope that that makes sense. Again, if you were not sure if you would if you want to get the normal Woma or this one, the Sharon by C, the normal Woma is pricier for a reason. Let's just say that. I like the formula of the normal Woma more than this one. But that's personal preference. I still think it's a nice foundation. Then the last product that I have in this tier is also a brush set. But this is a brush set that... 2 out of 4 I love a lot. I use quite often. So that is why it's here. Because it's a set of 4 and half I don't use. So the other half I do. Does that make sense? So the brushes are from EcoTools. These are the on-the-go style kit. And the package, this is Clean Beauty Clean Planet. And this was that I could plant it. Which I still haven't done. But I will when it's planting time again. So yeah, this is the travel set. These two I don't use. I tried, it's not for me. These two though, I really do like. I like smaller handles. These are very, very small though. Very small handles. But these I use for my face. So... But for my creams, that's what I mean. So if I use my KKW stick, I like these, this one for it a lot. So it's very nice and precise. And this one I really like to use also for cream bronzer, for instance. Now it is almost a little bit more precise than the one that I have from Alien Cosmetics. But I really like it. I can also use it for normal bronzers, these brushes don't drag on my face. And that is what I want. I want to be able to place, I want to be able to blend, preferably all with one brush. I really like these two, so that's why they are higher. Because I use them crap ton. Yeah. Okay. So the next tier is going to be amazeballs. So these are products that are amazeballs. And this is kind of... Is it ranked? No. Maybe a little, but not a lot. Yes, let's just go with the first product that I have here in this tier, which is... let's go to an eye pencil and a lip pencil. These are both from Catrice. So the eye pencil that I have here is the 20 Hour Ultra Precision Gel Eye Pencil. It's a waterproof one in the shade Mauve. These were from their new line and I bought two colors. And this color, I really do like the color. But right now, it's not really a color that I go for a lot. It's a very, very deep, dark, almost grayish purple. Very, very pretty, but and it stays in my waterline all day. I love the formula. It's just the color I really do like. Yeah, I really do like, but not as much as the other color that I will mention in just a bit. These are all amazeballs. What can I say? Then the next thing that I'm going to mention is the plumping liner from Catrice. Now, I have quite a few of these and I really, really like them. I also bought a clear, but the clear isn't in this video yet because I want to try it out more. This is the red one. This is the shade Stay Powerful and it is just a very nice red. And they, yes, they plump. They do. Yeah, and I wanted to have a red lip pencil. Now, this is not as basically neutral as the one that I use as an eye pencil. I don't want to use this as an eye pencil because it has a minty in it, just so you know. So this is more, it is almost a little bit more of a bluer red. So if you're looking for that, then this could be it. And yes, it does plump the lips a hint. Not a lot, but just a little. Okay, then I'm going to go to... Let's go to some eyeshadow palettes then, because I have them here. Let's go to... Unique Beauty. Now, I received the collection from Unique Beauty, the festive collection in PR. I initially wanted to rank them as the collection, but I was like, no, I'm going to rank them separately because I was in the understanding that you could buy everything separately. Because that is what happened with the... I thought I saw it separately on the site. I'm sure I did. But anyway, they're ranked separately for now. I'm going to go to the palette that is my least favorite out of that collection, and that is Tis the Season. Now, maybe you would have guessed if you've seen my video on it. Quality wise, it's very, very good. It's just that the color story kind of throws me off a little bit. Yeah, it's the blue. For me, it's not a shade that I use often. It's not a color that I use often. The look that I ended up with, I really, really loved. And again, I think that the quality is very, very good. It's just color story wise, it's not my favorite. What can I say? Preference. Yes, preference. I also have an affiliate code with Unique Beauty in case you want to save some money. Okay, let's next go to this. The Moonspell Volume 2 from Lunar Beauty. I love the whole aesthetic. I have been wanting a sister to the first one for ages. And here we have it. And I think that the outside really kind of gives you a feel for what's in the inside. Because the color story is pretty, well, warm. Right? But, well, is it warm though? Because pink is technically a cool color, right? Pink and purple are technically cool colors. But for me, they are on the warmer side of... I don't know. But it's a red, pink, purple. It's that kind of palette. And I loved the looks that I did with it. It's not my most favorite color story right now though. But I am finding myself really changing up my preferences of colors. Because last year, or beginning of this year, this was completely my vibe of color story. Now I'm just going a little bit more towards the greener that you don't see right now. But that's kind of more greener mustard yellow. That's kind of what I vibe with right now. But I really did like it. And I thought that the looks that I created were very, very pretty. I think the quality is very, very nice as well. Yeah, and the whole aesthetic... I think the palette is amazeballs. Yeah, and that's it. And then with, you know, again, the whole aesthetic, it's... I love this a lot. And yeah, That's it. So the next palette that I'm going to go to is the Age of Opulence by Beauty Bay. And this is a hint higher than the Lunar Beauty is because I just like this color story a little bit more right now. I know I just mentioned the Corpse Bride, but I'm also really vibing with neutrals right now. And this is just a little bit darker. It gives me more options. I really like the quality of the Beauty Bay formula. And I like that it is also neutrals in here. I like the fact that I can really, the looks that I created there, there's just something about kind of the tealy blue and then a gold. Oh, I love that. I felt so luxe. So luxe when I wore that palette on my eyeballs. Yes. Yes, I'm dramatic. I know. Let's go to MUA. MUA released two new liquid blush shades, and I bought all two. The other one that I have to try out a little bit more because I haven't used it as much, so that will be in next month. It's just I want to know how the color is, basically how I like the color. But this one is in the shade Cherry Pop. This is a red blush. I love the formula of these blushes, and when I put this on, especially now, I don't have it on today, obviously. Of course, I don't have it on today. But this is a color that I am a little bit more careful with. If you are deeper than me, though, you can go a little bit more ham. So basically, I just tapped it on my hand, and that's usually how I use blushes like this. I'm just tapping it out, and it is for me already that it's a red blush. I think it's very, very pretty. I did not think I would like it as much as I do, because I also have the shade Watermelon, which is a little bit more, maybe it's a little bit lighter even, the shade. I don't know, but I really, really like these. And I love the formula as well, so that is why it is higher, because it's just amazeballs. And it has been a shade that I have been using for a very, very much often. Bad English, I'm well aware. Let's go next to this one from Madage Beauty London. And this color I'm going to talk about. I have a whole bundle of their liquid lipsticks, which was from their Pride 2021 collection. But this shade I really like. The formula on all of them is the same, but this is the shade that I use most. I could also pull this shade, because this one is very, very pretty as well. And again, the formula is very nice. If there's a color in there that you like, and you like liquid lipsticks, I don't think you will be disappointed. This is a very nice, comfortable formula. It is not extremely dry, or at least I don't feel it's a liquid lipstick. Yeah, what can I say? But the color surprised me so much. So when I hold it like this, I'm like, it's very, very bright. And then when I put it on, it's very pretty. And I can also layer on top a gloss. It does not need to be a gloopy gloss, but I, you know, and a little bit sheer, that was the word I was looking for. But I love this color. I really, really love this color. So this is the reason that it is here. Next, I'm going to go to, let's go to these from Lunar Beauty, the liquid lipstick and the glosses. Let's start with the liquid lipstick. I love this liquid lipstick formula. It is a very nice thin formula. It reminds me a little bit of the Black Moon Cosmetics formula that I love with a passion. This is maybe a hint thicker. Not by much, but it is not drying. I think it's a very, very pretty color as well. And this is the shade Hallow's Eve. It's a very nice, it's a darker orange, but still on me, very, very pretty. And I really like it. And I can layer, if I want to, his glosses on top as well. But tap them on. So usually if I use a gloss on top of a lipstick or a liquid lipstick, I put the gloss on my finger and then I tap. That's how I use it. Then let's go to the glosses. Let's go to the one that I thought would be my favorite, but it's actually not. Let's go to this one, the shade Coven. I thought this would be my favorite. It is, but for everyday use. They smell heavenly, but for just an everyday gloss, this is the one that I really, 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 really love. Because it's just very complementary to my complexion. It's not overpowering. It's not gloopy, but it has substance, so it stays put. And it's just very, very pretty. So I really like it. The one actually from the glosses that is my favorite, and I did not think it would be, is the shade Bitchcraft. There is just something about the color. It's just so, so pretty. So yeah, that one is my favorite out of the three. I love my glosses. What can I say? Let's next go to another gloss. I actually thought it was a liquid lip... liquid lipstick, but it is a gloss. And it is from Unique Beauty. It's also from the winter collection or the holiday collection. I got this one in PR. And this is the shade Ruby. This is a red gloss, but it also has an... When I look at it in my camera and in my mirrors, it is a blue toned red. But when I look at it with my eyes, I can also see an orange. So it just has a little bit of everything. And it's just so pretty. The applicator doesn't pick up a lot though, so you kind of have to layer it a little bit. But I think it's worth it. Look how pretty this is. This is just so... I can use it on top of my lips. I can use it on top of a red liner. I can use it with a brown liner. I can use it with an orange liner. I can use it on top of a lipstick as well. It is just such a unique... It's such a pretty red gloss. But because the base is translucent, it's a clear gloss with red... Yeah, basically red pigment in it. But because it's not a red gloss, but a transparent gloss with red pigment, it doesn't bleed. Does that make sense? Because it doesn't make sense for me, but that is how I feel. The gloss substance is thick enough that it stays where I place it and it doesn't travel. And I just also sheared out. It's very, very pretty. So if I just tap it on, it's also very pretty. It's, I don't know, a little bit fiery. I really, really like it. I love it. Yes. Then the last thing that I'm going to mention for this category is an eye pencil. And it's also from Catrice. And it is in the shade Berry Plum. And this is a shade that I love with a passion, especially now. Here it is. This is just such a... Yeah, a berry plum color. And it's very unique in my collection. It has a slight sparkle in it. It's just... It's so, so pretty. Yeah, and that was the Amazeballs collection. Now we are going to go to the... You have to pry it out of my cold dead hands. These are products that I... Some of them I use... Almost every day, at least every day, every time that I do my makeup. So there's one product that I use almost every day. So let's go to the eyeshadow palettes that I have in this tier. These palettes are not ranked. They are not, because it's a preference thing and that changes daily for me. So these are just the palettes that... Well, you have to pry out of my cold dead hands. I love them equally. So yeah, that's... That is it. I love them all equally. What can I say? Let's start with Unique Beauty because it's on top, because they are the two smallest ones. I have here the Dark Souls and I have the Warm Autumn. So this is the Dark Souls palette. And I think it is just stunning. And it really, really reflects the outside. I really had a lot of fun with this palette. I had a lot of fun with the entire collection. I think that the quality is very, very good. I think that all the palettes work together beautifully. And they complement each other. And they complement her entire collection as well. So yeah, the Dark Souls palette. It's just so stunning. Also, if you want the Chinchilla from Sigil, this you can get a similar vibe with. Not all, but at least one of the looks that I love to do with the chinchilla, I can kind of replicate it with this. You have three mattes, you have a white. Yeah, the white I did use. And if you love a matte white, you will definitely love this one. It's not a shade that I use a lot, but to blend out, I could very much use it. Or to just, you know, with an all matte look, do a white inner corner. It's very, very pretty. But these are the two shades that I love to use, and then I use this one in the outer corner, and then this one I actually pulled all over the lid. But I love the fact that you can go very, very dark. But I all and yeah, this shade, it's just so stunning. It's just so stunning. Can you see the shifts that it has? It has purple, it has blue, it has green. It's just stunning. Yeah, what can I say? It's stunning. Okay, then the next palette that I'm going to show you, which is honestly, I like a hint better because it's just a color story that I love very, very much this time of year. And that's the Warm Autumn. Yeah, this is the most pretty. green shimmer. It reminded me a little bit of the lightest green shimmer that is in the Tribe palette from Juvia's Place. And this one stays green on me, which is also very, very fun. Yeah, I love this color story. I think it complements an olive complexion very, very well. And it is really what I want to play with right now. What can I say? Quality, again, it's amazing. Yes. Then the other two eyeshadow palettes are very much a different vibe. So let's start with the one that I have on top, which is from VE Cosmetics. And it's the Grimoire 2.0, which is basically three palettes in one, or at least in my opinion it is. And if you want to know what I'm talking about, go watch the video that I did with it. I created three looks with this palette. They are all very, very stunning. And what I love so much about this is that you can go very monochromatic. So you can stay in their own colors, but you can mix and match. The first look that I did with this palette was a black and red look, and it was stunning. It was stunning. I love the mattes in this. I love the fact that you can... I want to say you can go happy with this. No, this is a grungy palette. This is a dark palette. You can try and, you know, not go in as heavy-handed, but it's still, the looks that you're going to do with this are still dark and grungy. I don't know if it is still in stock though, because this was a limited edition, I know that. And it is a pretty big bulky packaging, but yeah, I think that the quality is amazing. You have your very dark matte row, then you have kind of a middle color row, and then here you have a shimmer row. Only this shade is a satin. It's not a very foiled red, it's a satin. And the shimmers that are in here are a little bit more of your old school traditional shimmers, which I think are very, very nice. I love a formula like that. I also love the very foiled shades, but on my eyes, especially because they're older, this kind of formula is just a little bit more flattering. And especially in the darker colors, I think it's a stunning palette, hence that it is here. The next palette, which is also the last palette that I'm going to mention in this video. Is my falsie still on? Yeah, maybe you can guess. It's the 669 from Martine Cosmetics. Now, Martine Cosmetics is a Belgian indie brand. The site is in French, so... what I usually do is Google Translate. Fortunately for me, my kind of high school French is still... I still know enough French words that I can kind of guess what's going on. But if I want to know exactly, I use Google Translate. Yeah, honestly. But this is the color story. So I did a video with this. I had a lot of fun with this palette. This is just such a pretty grungy color story. I have mentioned this palette a few times. There are also a few multi-chromes in here. So let's see. This shade. And if you see in the mirror, you can see one of the shifts that it has. So this is the shade Freya, which has a shift. At least two. Then we have this one, which is called Euphemia. Which has looks here to be red-pink, but it also has a green-orange in it. And then the last one is this one, which is the shade Medusa. This shade is so stunning. It is a teal with a purple and basically a pink in it as well. It's so, so stunning. I thought that the mattes performed very, very well. And there are also different blacks in here. So basically you have one true matte... true deep dark black, a neutral black. Then this is, in my eyes at least, a very deep gray. If you want to see the shades swatched next to each other, all the black shades, go watch my video, because I show them side by side there. But yeah, this is just such a cool grungy color story that I think it's a very, very, very nice quality, and it makes me really interested in what the brand is going to do next. That is my opinion. Yes, let's go to the last things that I have here. And these are things that are used... two are used every time I do my makeup and one is used daily. So let's save that one for last then. Let's start with this from She Glam. And it's the Freckle Tint. The Freck Please Freckle Tint. Ever since I got this, I have been using this. Because I like the color. And I really like the applicator. So the color, I have it on my face today. The color is... yeah, it's a warmer... when I swatch it, it is a little bit of an almost an orangey, warmer brown. But when it dries down to, well, basically what I have here. So not completely cool, but it pulls a little bit... they're not as cool as, for instance, this one, which is from me. It's my own. It's a little bit warmer than that, but it is cool enough to not... to work together, if that makes any sense. Really do like this one, and I can see myself repurchasing this actually. So yeah, then the next thing that I'm going to mention is eyeliner. Because you remember what I mentioned with the Makeup Revolution one, right? That it kind of bleeds. I actually used an eyeliner from Madage Beauty London that was one of those dippers, you know? That one stayed put. So I was like, Catrice has a new one, let me try that one. So I bought it. This is the no parabens, no microplastic particles, no PEGs. Edit, very tiny letters. But this is the 24-hour brush liner with coconut water. It's the waterproof. This is so nice. This is so nice. I have tried their older formula of this before. And while it was still nice, it kind of, it tended to do this to my eyelids when it dried. This doesn't do that. It also doesn't bleed. So I'm so, so happy. And yes, it is waterproof because it stays on all freaking day. I have it on today underneath the funky liner. Yeah, it's a very, 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 very nice liner. Did I say it's a very nice liner? I did, right? Then the last thing that I'm going to mention of the video is something that I use every day. It's usually downstairs. I'm glad that I didn't forget to bring it up. It is from Essence. It is a lip oil. Now they have expanded the stuff we have in store here for Essence, and this one, I have seen this on the sites, but I can get it in store now, and I was like, let me try it. So this is the Essence Lip Care Booster, the lip serum, 10% peach oil. It moisturizes, replenishes, plumps and boosts. Does it plump? I don't think so, but I love this. The only thing is, it has a brush applicator. I don't really mind a brush applicator, but it doesn't, because I can show you, the brushes are a little bit smaller. Can you see that the applicator is a little bit smaller than a normal doe foot? So if it will have been longer, you can basically pick up more product and deposit more product. But this the applicator is a little bit too short for me to smear on the lips in one go, so I have to dip back. But this goes with me when I go outside a lot of the time, because it's then in my pants pocket or in my jacket pocket. And the best part is the component doesn't leak. It doesn't dry out my lips. It's very nice and hydrating, and I love it. So yeah, guys, that was it. That was the best of beauty of the month of October. And it was a long one because I have tried out a bunch and I had thoughts. Yes. And that was it. If you want to see more in-depth thoughts, go to my channel, because I have done videos with, well, almost everything. At least the eyeshadow palettes. Yeah, that's what I have done videos with. So, yeah, for additional thoughts, if I have room, I will link some videos. I will also put some videos underneath the cards, but otherwise just search my channel, use the search function, and you will find them. This was it for today. Let me know your thoughts. Have you tried any of these, and what are your opinions about them? Yes, thank you so much for watching. Before you leave, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below, because it both helps me out tremendously. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you super soon in my next one. Bye, guys.